action and silos theorem, there is a prerequisite for this part, and that is group. You all have studied group in your third semester. So what is group? I'm just giving you a brief revision. So what is group? A group is a non-empty set with a binary operation. It has four properties. Number one, closure. If you take any two elements from the set and use the binary operation, and the element which you are getting again belongs to the set, then it satisfies the closure property. Associativity. You have already studied matrices. Matrices follow associativity. And same as the group, the same associative property is there in group. Then the identity. Identity is also there in matrices. 1, 0, 0, 1 in 2 plus 2 matrices. And the inverse. There is also inverse in matrices if the determinant is non-zero. So all these properties, when get satisfied, then it is group. Abelian group, all the four properties are satisfied, and along with that, the commutative function, the commutative property is getting satisfied, then it is known as Abelian group. Then direct product. If two groups are cyclic or commutative, and the order of the two groups have a GCD 1, then the groups are using direct product, and the direct product of the group is also cyclic or commutative. Then the question arises, what is order of the group? Order of group is the cardinality of the group, and cyclic group is denoted by this form. Then what is group action? Group action is basically a function from G cross S to S. It is known as the left action because the group is in the left side. So it satisfies this property, and these are the two properties which need to satisfy. If you take any two elements of the group and an element from the set S, it must be non-empty, then G1, G2 function of S equals to G1 function, G2 function S, and E function S equals to S, where E is the identity element of the group. Let's take this as fact. This is Cauchy's theorem. You already have studied Cauchy's theorem. Any group of finite order N is divisible by a prime P. When the group contains an element of prime of the order P and a subgroup of order P. Any group of order P square is commutative where P is prime, and every group of order P cube is not simple, where P and Q are primes. What is simple? Any group which does not have any normal subgroup is called a simple group. A group having normal subgroup is not simple. Okay, then what is normal subgroup? A group where AH equals to HA is called a normal subgroup, where A belongs to G, for all A belongs to G. There are three theorems of silos: silos first theorem, silos second theorem, and silos third theorem. Silos first theorem. Let G be a finite group of order P to the power Rm, where P is a prime and R and M are positive integers. P and M are relatively prime, where that is their GCD is 1. Then G has a subgroup of order P to the power K for all K between 0 and R. Silo's second theorem says the same thing, where you can just see that it just gives any two silo P subgroups are conjugate and isomorphic. And Silo's third theorem gives us the guarantee of number of silo P groups we are getting. So here are some questions which I would like to discuss. You already have already said enough. Then, so the questions are basically become simple when you know all the facts. So any group of order 15 is commutative or cyclic or not simple. Any group of order 3 is cyclic because it is a group of prime order. Any group of order 5 is cyclic because it is a group of prime order. So their direct product is also cyclic. A cyclic group is also commutative. So it is commutative. And you can see that they have normal subgroups of order 3 and order 5. So they are not simple. Also, I have mentioned in this slide that any group of order PQ is not simple. So that is also a reason for that. Then the second question, any group of order Pn is where P is prime and P greater than N contains a normal subgroup of order P. By Silo's theorem, we claim that there is a subgroup of order P, and by Silo's third theorem, we can see that P cannot be divided by 1 plus Nk where N is greater than. Where n is greater than 0, and any group of order 1, 2, 2, 5 is commutative. This question came in our exam also. I did it wrong. but it is very simple. It should be 5 square into 7 square. A group of order p square is commutative, 5 square is commutative. A group of order 7 square is commutative. So their direct product is also commutative. Thank you.